The way we're able to really build and now sustain our edge is I think, one specific way in particular. We were able to find a place in the world, a market, where our device not only brought very high value, and this is in urology, but it was also a place where competition wasn't entrenched. We were able to build our company, figure out some processes, get profitable, make mistakes, in a world where unencumbered largely by competition. So we built a small, successful company in urology. And then from there, we were able to launch into those places. We still had very high value, but there were competition. You know, there were competitors. And so it was now from a foundation of profitability and processes and good people, great people, that we're able to compete and meet those competitors out in the marketplace. And so find a place where you can build a company and sustain it without competition, and then that's where you launch into those other places. The thing that we need to do in order to sustain an advantage over time is we got to look back to the personality of the company primarily and say we're an innovative company. So that's where we're going to focus, and that's how we'll sustain being a first mover. We will continue to innovate, put new products out there that matter, that help to build the business. And that means penetrating and delivering MIS, minimally invasive surgery, around the world. First world countries, third world countries, making it available to everyone. So as a fundamental growth engine. But behind that too are investments that we make and will continue to make in making surgery better. And so over time, not only is there growth for the company, but there's a betterment of surgery, so it becomes less and less invasive for the patients. Yeah, competition for Intuitive, I think, comes from three different places. One is direct competition. There are big companies and small companies both who are building robots to do soft tissue surgery that are competing right with us. And so that's kind of an easy one to understand and react to. There's a second class of competition that looks nothing like a robot. We treat patients who have some sort of disease. There will be drugs or other therapies that also treat that disease. And so to the extent those are less invasive, that's great. It's great for us, it's great for our kids. Probably not great for our company, but at the time we will adapt and figure it out. Maybe there's a synergy there that matters. And then the third area is one that honestly caught us a little bit by surprise. And it was absolutely knowable. And that's as we got into those areas that had competition. They didn't have a robot, so they had to fight back. And they fought back on the perception of value around robotics. They looked at safety, was it safe? They looked at cost, was it cost effective? And so they funded studies, right, to look at the perception and the value of robotics. And so that is an area that I think for any company, you need to look at those people you're going to disrupt and what tools do they have to fight back and prepare for it. The hardest part of a journey is finding a place where you have value and you can build a small company, right? Something that's sustainable and profitable. And then from there, figure out who you are as a company and then react to the competition, right? I mean, it's not that there's not plenty along the way, but that first part, that's the key. I mean, it's rare that a small company fails because of competition. It just fails because they can't figure out their, you know, how to make themselves viable.